You know what? You know what? Y'all bitches stay hitting the dislike button. Like, seriously. Y'all will dislike anything. Like, I'm trying to figure this shit the fuck out. You know what YouTube really needs to do? Because I'm looking as I'm talking to you guys. YouTube needs to put somebody's picture. So, whenever you dislike a video, your little icon and name need to pop up on the fucking screen so I could see who the hell disliking my shit. Like, I don't really care if you dislike the shit, but the video will be like 2 seconds in.
I don't like her eyeshadow today. I don't like those earrings she has on. I don't like that white shirt. I just don't. I don't like myself. I'm gonna dislike it.
That's what the fuck y'all be doing. Like, what's up, divas and divos? It's your girl April. So you guys already know what it is. It's Real Talk Wednesday, the Wednesday before the new year. Okay, so I hope all you guys had like a great Christmas. For real, like, ugh, I'm so goddamn hot right now. Oh my god, I know I always be bitching to y'all like I'm hot, but trust and believe me, it be fucking hot in my room. I always is hot in here. And I got the fan on and I'm hot. The shirt collar is a little bit up too much because it's hot. I'm really uncomfortable because I'm hot. That's why this headscarf is making me hot. Oh my god. Even these eyelashes is making me hot, okay? Anyway, so I hope you guys had a great Christmas. I had a great time, a great ass Christmas, because I know you guys are probably like, girl, you got enough kids. But I love to watch my kids and my grandkids get happy over some shit. Like, you know what I mean? Like, so I'm not going to tell you what I bought them because I don't really think that y'all need to know. Nor do y'all really fucking care. But I will just tell y'all one thing. I bought Mumsy, my grandson Tinky, and my grandson Sweetums. And I know y'all probably like, every last one of those names that you mentioned is just different. So I did name them all. That's all their nicknames. And they go by their nicknames. This Sweetums, Tinky Man, but we call him Tinky for short, and Mumsy. That's her nickname. That's not her real name. Her real name is Janaya. Tinky's real name is Cameron, and Sweetum's real name is Jerron Jr. So anyway, I bought them, all three of them, a tablet. Okay, now mind you, Mumsy's 9. She got an iPad, and I mean, it wasn't really hers to begin with, but she took over, and I just was like, you know what? Hey, just take it. But Tinky will be 2. January 2nd, and Sweetums will be 4 January 12th. So a 4-year-old with a tablet, that's not too bad. But what 2-year-old do you know that needs a tablet? So, but he knows how to work it, so it keeps him busy and occupied. It keeps Sweetums busy and occupied. Both of my kids was like, this was the best thing ever, mommy. They love it, you know. And that's just one thing that I bought them, but I bought them a bunch of stuff. But yes, the little tablets, it's crazy. The generation of kids these days are so much different from when I was a kid, definitely when I was a kid, and to even when I had my first child, you know what I'm saying? They're totally different. So it's like amazing to watch them interact with each other or with these little handheld devices. It's like crazy. Nobody don't go outside and play hopscotch and double dutch no more. Like I said to my daughter, we used to play double dutch when I was your age. She just looked at me like I had 10 heads and was like, what is double dutch? Like, I was like, just go Google it, because that's what y'all do anyway. Google that shit. Yeah, it's double dutch. I remember those days and missed them so much. But you know what? Life goes on, and there's trends and trends and trends and shit that just comes out and just attracts your attention. Well, there is one trend that I'm hoping to God, or maybe not even just one, but I'm hoping to God that this trend that has been trending for so fucking long now, not even in just 2016, but for many, 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 many fucking years, is the fucking tongue smacking. If y'all don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, now, I'm not really good at doing it, but I'm about to show y'all, because I had to show y'all on Instagram Live. I could not take that shit because I just was on YouTube that day and somebody's video came across my newsfeed. I'm not really sure why her video came across my newsfeed, because I don't watch her. She was tongue smacking, and what I call tongue smacking is you take the tongue and you hit it at the roof, you know. Well, girl. Yeah, girl. Why do people do that? Why do females do that? Can you guys answer the question for me? Why do bitches do that? He was gonna take me out for dinner, girl, but I decided not to go. Bitch, because your mouth is dry. That's why you hurt the roof of your mouth. That's why you ain't go, because you can't eat now. You done tongue smacked all fucking day long. The whole roof of your mouth is hurting, okay? That shit is hurting. Like, why do females do that? Young lady on Instagram told me that her grandmother told her that girls who do that be lying, okay? So, is that what it is? Like, when y'all be like, I can't even do it right, but you guys know what I'm saying? Like, and they do it with so much ease. Like, you know, like they've been practicing for a minute. Is that, because I'm trying to figure out, is it to be cute? Like, do you guys do it to be cute? Or is it because your mouth is dry? If your mouth is dry, bitch, get a drink, okay? Get a motherfucking drink. And then do that, right? I mean, I'm just trying to figure out, like, what is that all about? Like, I always hated that shit. Like, I fucking hate it. And it seems like it's just catching on more and more and more. And it seems like I've only noticed it in the black community. And you all know I'm part of the black community. And I have never done that. And I don't understand why people do it. And if somebody knows why, because I have gotten a reason already, it's because they lying. I don't really think it's just that. I think it's probably many of different fucking reasons of why these bitches be tongue smacking. They be loud with the shit, so you can hear them all the way on the other side of the room. You be doing shit. Did that bitch just tongue smack down the hallway? Oh, shit. That bitch was loud with it. Must be some real drama. And that's when it seems like they get loud with the tongue smacking. It's when it's more drama. The more the drama, the louder the tongue smack. Like, okay, is that? I mean, y'all explain that shit to me, because I'm fucking confused as a motherfucker about that whole shit, okay? Mm-hmm. And then the next one is, I mean, I've seen this before, 2016 too, and I just can't get it. But it seems like they have brought it back again. Now, I love the whole fact that people love to wear wigs. It's amazing. Wear your shit, bitch. Wear it the fuck out. But when you put in a whole fucking jar a fucking gel to slide and slick and slither down your motherfucking baby hairs, then bitch, you have went overboard. This shit has caught back on in the trend of 2016 for gluing the fucking wigs back down. Now, I thought we was over that shit. I mean, I've been stopped gluing my motherfucking wig down back in like 2010-11, because I just got tired of that shit. But if you really want to see a glued down motherfucking wig, then I will show you how to glue down a motherfucking wig. Matter of fact, go look on my channel. I had to upload an old video. I will give you the tea of how to really glue that motherfucker down. But anyway, they glue them down and they put the baby hairs down. Okay, why are we calling them baby hairs anyway? Babies, they baby hairs. When your ass is 20, bitch, you ain't got no baby hairs on your head anymore, okay? Your shit's been processed, damaged, cut the fuck off, dyed, and fried. That shit is not baby hairs. They're little hairs, okay? Bitch, that's a kitchen on your forehead. Let's just be real about the shit. But do y'all motherfuckers really have to fucking take a full bang? When I say a full motherfucking bang, that should be like a China cut bang. Y'all will have that shit fucking gel the fuck down and be like, my wig is laid, my hairline looks natural. What fucking hairline, bitch? You don't see the shit because your fucking bang is glued the fuck down and you calling it baby hair. Okay, I am so sick of seeing motherfucking bitches with their baby hairs. There's no reason to have so much freaking wispies or hairs glued down. Like, I'm personally not a huge fan of it anyway. I guess because I'm in my 40s and I've done that already. Never did the full bang. But, you know, we've given ourselves little baby hairs. That's cool. I will do it when the time is appropriate. However, I don't get carried away with it neither. I just think that less is a lot. You know, very little is a lot. You don't need a lot of baby hairs. It's not baby hairs. Babies have those hairs because they're called baby hairs. But when you have to take them and pull your whole motherfucking bang down, and that shit is like this long down to here, then we got a motherfucking problem. Okay? Is that because you don't want nobody to see your wig hairline? I'm sorry, but I'd rather the motherfucker see my wig hairline than have a whole bunch of glue and gel and hair pasted to my forehead. Could you only imagine when it gets hot out in this motherfucker? Okay, when it gets real hot out in this motherfucker, are you going to see these same females walking around with all this glue? I'll never forget when I was younger, Jam, the hair gel called Jam was so popular. But when it got fucking hot outside, that shit would melt like a motherfucker. I never got the opportunity to use it, but I seen it in its full freaking transitioning stage of melting from this to that. You know what I'm saying? Just from my friends. I never got to use it. I would always use like either the black gel or the clear gel or just some kind of pink gel. Whatever my mom bought for me is what I use. She always got the real cheap shit. And Jam was not cheap, okay? So that's the reason why I didn't have the opportunity to use it. However, I'm pretty glad I didn't because I wouldn't want anything melting on my fucking face. However, I can only imagine when this summer comes and you see all these females on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, whatever social media talking about, look at my edges is laid. Bitch, those is not edges. That's motherfucking baby hairs, okay? And that's not even motherfucking baby hairs. That's your fucking bang. That's your motherfucking full-blown bang. Let's not try to fool the community of social media. That's not baby hairs. That's not edges. That's a bang that you got slicked the fuck down. I just really hope that people don't keep doing that because I'm so tired of seeing that shit. Like, I just can't. Okay? It take a lot out of me now to freaking gel glue a wig down. They be having all kind of designs and shit, and squigglies and fucking unicorns and rainbows and fucking hearts and shit up on the side of their heads. Like, bitch, where you learn that at? I don't have the patience for that shit. Nor do I have enough fucking gel or glue to go the fuck around for that. I'm not going out buying gel every day. Not for that shit. Mm-mm. So those are the two things that I really would like for people to stop doing. Tongue smacking and this motherfucker and fucking gluing their fucking bangs down to their fucking foreheads and sideburns. That should be all their pee. You should get that shit. Oh, like seriously, don't do that. Those are just my pet peeves. And also, bitches that don't mind their motherfucking business. I know that this is never going to fucking stop. It doesn't matter what fucking year it is. Some of y'all nosy bitches is never gonna stop. Y'all gonna continuously complain about another bitch, what she got on, what she wearing, what she doing, how she look, how she talk, whatever. Just like me, I'm complaining about that fucking tongue smacking talk and shit. That shit's irritating though. But you know what I'm saying? The main focus and the main key is to stop worrying about what other people got going on in their life and worry about what the fuck you be doing, okay? This is what I said last week. Be happy with your fucking selves. And if you are happy with yourselves, you will not have no worries and no cares about what your next door neighbor or your down the street motherfucking fellow community person is doing. You won't give a fuck what anybody is doing. And I'm going to continue to keep minding my business. That's what the fuck I do. I just be minding my motherfucking business. I stay out of all types of drama because you know what? At the end of the day, I got my own drama and bullshit to go on with my life. You know what I'm saying? Other than that, let me tell y'all something. My last few days, or week rather, has been amazing. Like, just amazing, okay? I have been so happy and just in my own world and just so happy. You know what I'm saying? Like, really, I have been really, 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 really happy and consumed with just happiness. And I'm so happy about that. Like, I'm so fucking happy about that. And, of course, I will tell you guys in a later to come video. No, I ain't got no boyfriend. Not worried about that. You know, I have been talking to somebody on the phone every single day. And we have just been, it's crazy how life just, life scenarios changes the way you feel about a person. You know what I mean? And it's crazy that when you go through something in life, you have realized that that person that you left was the only person that really, really, truly loved you. And I know you guys are like, who the fuck are you talking about? I'm talking about my ex-husband, okay? You know, it's crazy because we talk to each other every single day. Every single day. And it's just weird. And I'm going to have to explain this to you guys in another real talk. But sometimes you have to go through some crazy foul shit in life. But anyway, so yes, this is going to be the last real talk of the year. So I hope y'all bitches who are doing those dumb things that I don't fucking like, please don't do them for 2017. If y'all is smacking y'all roof of your mouth right now with your tongue because you mad at a bitch because I just blew it out there and threw it out there, then I don't know what to tell you. But I will tell you this. If you have a real talk that you want to dish the fuck out, oh gosh, go ahead and send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Please put in the subject line real talk. And as well as that, is the email address is down below in the description box as well. And if you want to change the name of your characters in that email, then by all means, go ahead and do so. Please let me know ahead of time because a bitch be so forgetful sometimes. I will not know what the fuck is going on. Okay? So yes, let's get on to the real talk. All right, so that was for you guys. Okay, I got to read this one first. Okay, yes, hunties, yes. I just wanted to first say, start off by saying, I love your videos. You keep me laughing and you keep it real. You are one of the few YouTubers I watch that I feel still has authentic material. Keep up the good work. We need you. So I have a real talk for you. My name is Steven. You can use my real name. I don't care. Laugh out loud. First off, I wanted to start off by saying I'm 27 years old and I'm a gay black male. So I used to date a guy back in high school, back when I was 17 years old. We've been on and off because he's nice, but he's non-consistent. He doesn't take me out on dates. He's not that affectionate. He acts as if we're not dating at times. He's also under his family, which takes advantage of him. After going through so much drama and bullshit with him since I was 17, I decided to leave his ass alone for good. We talk every once in a while, but I made it clear that we will never be in a relationship again. He lies about dumb shit, and we've just grown apart as we become older. So to cut to the chase, I was always friends with his cousin. We talk every once in a while, and recently we started talking more. We have similar personalities and sense of humor. I've always been attracted to him. He's gay also, by the way. But never acted because I never reacted on my feelings towards his cousin because I always was on and off with his dumbass cousin. And it just felt wrong to me and I just didn't want to be that guy. But he's been on my mind a lot and I'm putting serious thought into maybe making a move for much more, not just for sex, laugh out loud. Me and my ex are not friends. We are just cool and I feel that since we failed to want to keep a good relationship with me, I don't owe him shit, but I go back and forth with this because I've known him for so long, but fuck it, I guess. Laugh out loud, please help. Laugh out loud, thanks in advance. Keep up the awesome work. And then in caps, he was like, P.S. Anybody who has anything to say about your daughter can get their ass beat. And I don't have no problem jumping in that shit because it's simply not okay to attack children, especially behind a damn computer screen. Give mumsy a hug for me. Smooches, thanks. Okay. Boo, Steven. I love the ending part. That's right. If you guys have not watched last week's Real Talk, then make sure you check it out because some dumb fuck was talking about my daughter and her weight and shit. And I put a screenshot on it for you guys to see. But yes. Okay, so Steven. Okay, honey. First of all, so Steven is 27 years old. He was messing on and off with this guy since he was 17. That's 10 years. But the guy never took him serious, like never took him serious enough. Didn't take him nowhere. Didn't take the relationship serious. Probably didn't tell him he loved him. Probably didn't buy him gifts for birthdays, holidays, or whatever. Just didn't take the relationship serious. I guess he took it as just a motherfucking joke. And I'm going to tell you what. People do get tired of that shit after a while. I'm sorry, but I'm not going to allow you to continuously string me the fuck along. So Steven got tired of it. And like he said, we not friends. We just converse back and forth once in a while. Every now and again, nothing major. We not even friends. So if a motherfucker is telling you they not even your goddamn friend, but they will hold a conversation with you for just a little bit, then bitch, he ain't your motherfucking friend. Okay? Steven ain't your friend. But that same guy, what we gonna call him? We gonna call him Matt. So the one that Steven was messing with for about 10 years, off and on, Mac. Mac has a cousin who is really cool with Steven. They're both men, and the cousin of Mac is also gay, but they have a lot of similarities. They have a lot in common. They speak to each other, and he's attracted to him. But he's going back and forth with himself, like, should I let his feelings out and react on my feelings toward him, or should I not, because I used to date old boy, his cousin Mac, back then. Listen, let me tell you something. I'm gonna tell you this. There be some codes that people be going by. I don't know. Some of these fucking codes and rules to dating is bullshit, but I'm gonna tell you what. The rule is this. If the motherfucker is not treating you right and not acknowledging you as a human being and not giving you love, affection, and respect, you dump they fucking ass. And if your friend down the street wanna fuck with him, then bitch, go ahead, because that be your headache, not mine. I could care less. You already knew what the fuck I was going through, okay? However, you and his cousin have a lot of things going on together, very similar traits, and you guys can hold a conversation, have good times together. Let me tell you something. If you continuously worry about what the fucking world think about you, then you gonna continuously worry about what the world think about you, okay? Let me tell you something. Let me tell you this. My brother, I'm 42, so he gotta be like 38. My other brother, I have two brothers. And he's the one that's gay. And for the longest, he wouldn't tell nobody. He didn't tell nobody, but I knew. But nobody knew. Nobody was told. My father didn't know. My other brother didn't know. But I knew. I could just tell when I would talk to him and the things that he liked to do. And I finally just was like, are you gay? You're gay, right? And he was like, what? You know, basically, how did you know? I know these things. But here's the thing. Why are you hiding that shit? Like, stop hiding it. You worried about what people gonna think about you? Like, are you serious right now? Fuck what everybody think. So, Steven, what I'm trying to get you to feel is this. Fuck what everybody think. If his family don't like the fact that you dating his cousin, oh, well, you were not really even dating Mac, okay? Because he didn't even treat you like you was important. He didn't even treat you like you was his significant other. You weren't even his girlfriend or boyfriend, whatever you want to call it, no disrespect, but you weren't in a serious relationship with him. He didn't take care of you. He didn't do anything for you. He didn't wash your clothes, rub your feet, take you out to eat, bring you to the movies, hold your hand in the park, bring you to meet his family. None of that shit. He didn't do any of that. So why the fuck are you worried about what he gonna think or anybody in his so-called family membership gonna think? All right, y'all weren't even a couple. In my eyes, I wouldn't even think y'all as a couple. Y'all was young, first of all, back then, so that really don't count. And then as you got older, he could have matured some, but he's still acting dumbfounded, like stupid dumb. And if you guys are like, what the fuck is stupid dumb? Stupid dumb is when your ass is really fucking dumb, okay? So he acting stupid dumb, and you worried about, oh, going back and forth with your feelings. Let me tell you something. You live one time, one fucking lifespan you got. I don't know about all of this other shit about being reincarnated and shit like that. I be feeling that way sometimes, like people being reincarnated. But I'm gonna tell you what, for this lifespan, for this life that you got right now on earth, you are to enjoy it to your fullest. You are 27 years the fuck old. I would give anything to go back to those days and ages, okay? 27 years old. Wow. That would seem like so long ago to me. And it is your youth. It is time to have fun and enjoy life and find someone that really appreciates you and loves you for who you are. Stop worrying about what everybody else think and worry about everybody else's feelings, because at the end of the day, them same motherfuckers that you worried about don't give two fucks about you, okay? Don't get two fucks about you. Trust and believe, I was in that same type of relationship, and I was so blinded because I really thought that, oh, I was being treated good when this nigga's so busy going to New York fucking dirty bitches with his little ass motherfucking dick, and then writing on Facebook how my daughter needs to lose weight and how he only here to use me and I'm ugly and all of this shit and I'm fat. Like, nigga, you weigh like 300 pounds. What is you talking about? I'm fat? Okay, well, whatever. We not gonna body shame, because I could care how your weight is, but you should not be talking about no fucking body. Especially when your dick is like this size of a chapstick. Yes, like a chapstick, okay? And on top of that, is this size and you only last 2 minutes? Like, dude, please. And you be pumping like you got something going on. Like, where did you do that at? I be just looking like, are you serious right now? Are you really motherfucking serious? Let me tell you. So, let me tell you something, Steven. Enjoy your life. And if you are feeling him and you are liking him, then sweetheart, boo-boo, Get it on, okay? And enjoy your life. This is what I be saying about people. Everybody be so worried about what other people think. Let me tell y'all something. I'm going to tell y'all this real quick because I'm gonna, like I said, I'm going to explain it to y'all in another video. But do y'all really think that I give a fuck about how y'all feel about me being back with my ex-husband? Do you really fuck? Do y'all think that I really give a fuck about who don't like the idea? That if my mama don't like it, you think I give a fuck about if anybody that I know don't like the shit? You think I really give a fuck? Like, really? No, I don't fucking care. Because if I did care, then I would be miserable for the rest of my motherfucking life. That is the reason, like I have told you guys before in a prior video, I don't date black men because of the affection and the way I feel about this man still, okay? I've always loved him. Regardless, I've always loved him. I've never stopped loving him, okay? You guys always see me using him as an example in my video, but sometimes it'd be a little bit too harsh. I'd be bashing him. I bashed him sometimes because I just be trying to get it out my system and try to get over it, but you can't get over something that you really truly love, you know what I'm saying? And like he said, I've never called you my ex-wife. You is my wife. You my wife, okay? And so do you really think that I give a fuck about anybody saying, oh girl, why are you messing with him again, or why are you back with him, or why is y'all about to get married again? I don't give a fuck about what everybody think and feel. This is my life. I'm a grown-ass woman. And who gonna learn the lesson? Me, not nobody else out there. If you don't like it, you don't like it, or you don't like it, then you know what? I don't care. You know what I'm saying? I like sometimes when people don't like what the fuck I do, because then they leave me the fuck alone. You know what I'm saying? But the moral of the story is, you got one life to live. Enjoy that shit to the fullest. And if this is who you want to be with, and you deserve happiness, and you deserve affection, and to be recognized and acknowledged, motherfucker, react and act on them fucking feelings and let his ass the fuck know. Because a closed mouth don't get fed. You know what I'm saying? If you don't say nothing, what the fuck? You think he... Not a lot of people is mind readers, Steven. Okay? Not a lot of people is mind readers. So act on that shit and get to know him even better, okay? Yes, you are so right. It is time to move on in life. It's about to be 2017. What you two need to do, if I were you, I would invite him out to a nice dinner. You and him go to a movie on New Year's Eve, or make him a nice dinner at your place if you got your own place. Just in general, try to include him in it, okay? So that way you could bring in the new year with him, and you can have a conversation with him and let him know your true feelings. I'm pretty sure he may feel just the same way as you, but some people may feel the same way as you, meaning he don't want to say nothing because you dated his cousin, but he really is feeling you. So let it be known, sweet thing. Let it be known, hunty. Okay, yes. What would you guys do if you were in a situation? Because I'm just saying. And if any motherfuckers got anything to say about Mumsy, like he said, you can get that ass beat. I'm just fucking saying. Okay, so this one right here is titled Real Talk Wednesday Help. I'm ruining my relationship. Hey, Miss April, first off, let me say I've been watching you since forever. I am 24 now, and I see you as my auntie in my head that I can get advice from. Let's just call me Amy and my boyfriend Craig. Well, to start, I'm in the best relationship. Miss April, I have never been this happy in my life. My boyfriend loves and cherishes me, and I have never experienced this before. We have been together a little over a year now, and our relationship is perfect with the exception of me. I lost around 80 pounds recently, and for some reason, I'm still not happy. I complain about my weight, talk down on myself constantly. It's like the word vomit, and I even get so down that I deny him sex because I don't feel pretty enough. To make matters worse, Craig plays basketball. Girls constantly push me to the side when they see him. I mean, some of these girls are bad as fuck. Greg constantly shuts the girls down, reassures me of how beautiful I am, but I always feel like I am not worthy of him or that he can do better. Miss April, I am so blessed to have him in my life, but I'm so scared he's going to get tired and leave me because of my self-esteem. Do you and your subscribers have any advice for me? Thank you so much for the time. I'm inserting some pictures. I'm 5'9", by the way, and he's 7'3". Damn, he tall. Shit. Black hair with bangs was before I lost weight. Everything else is recent. But she's so cute, though. Like, come on. She got some nice teeth, too. She cute. What is she talking about? That motherfucker is tall as hell. There's a picture with the both of them standing next to each other. Like, goddamn, girl. You like a little midget next to him. He's so cute, though. Now, listen, let me tell you something, Amy. I think that's what you wanted me to call you, right? If you didn't, I guess you're going to be Amy now. Yes, you did. Let me tell you something, Amy. Let me tell you something, girlfriend. It seems that when we want to lose weight, before I was this size, I was smaller than this. Last year around this time, I was smaller than this, okay? And I still was complaining about my weight and the size I am. I don't think as women, sometimes we are never happy about ourselves. And, you know, I think it has a lot to do with the girls that we see on social media, them little skinny-ass females that be coming around him trying to flaunt they stuff. I think that sometimes is a real intimidation to us. And I was just saying this last week, because I feel like that sometimes. I look at myself in the mirror and I put myself down. I be like, oh my God, look at my bread roll. Look at my stomach. I'm fat. I got to put on a girdle. Or when I take my makeup off, I be feeling like a certain type of way, like I'm not pretty enough. And who's going to want me because my teeth is jacked up. And I'm going to go lose all this weight. And I'm going to go get my teeth fixed. And I'm going to do all of this so that way I can find a boyfriend. And then I be like, girl, you stupid for even thinking that way. Because if the person can't accept you for who you are, then you don't even need to be bothered with them. And then that brings me back to the person that I love so dearly and who loves me so dearly. He loved all of this. I was like this when he was with me and he loved all of it, okay? However, we do criticize ourselves a lot more than others do. And you know what I'm saying? A lot of us be like, don't body shame. And we shouldn't. But regardless of what a person's size is, they're happy regardless. And then again, they may not be happy, but you really don't know what they're going through inside. You know what I'm saying? And just like with these bad bitches, like you said, that be at his basketball games, them bitches probably ain't nothing but a bunch of whoremongers, okay? And your boyfriend already know that. And then again, let's think about it like this. Just because you, Amy, because you find those girls to be badass, beautiful, bomb bitches, what makes you think that he does, okay? Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, okay? And what I may find attractive, you may find fucking butt-ass, ugly, and disgusting. And what you may find attractive, I might just be like, girl, please, that bitch is butt-ass, ugly, okay? So beauty is in the eye of the beholder. It is what this person is attracted to. And you are his type. Obviously, if you weren't, he would have never stepped to you from the beginning, okay? So here's my thing. If you want to lose more weight, 80 pounds is a lot. Girlfriend, I wish you was at the gym with me. You can motivate me. I'll be your best motherfucking friend, okay? I would love to lose 80. Well, I don't know about 80 because I weigh 215. So 80 pounds. Let's see. I'm going to just do the math real quick because I don't really know. 80 pounds off of 215. Let's see. 215 take away 80. Well, yeah, no, I don't want to lose 80 pounds because I would be 135 pounds and a bitch ain't trying to be that motherfucking thin, okay? I don't want to be anywhere under like 180. I don't want to be. So what do I got to do? If I want to be 180, I got to lose 35 pounds. That's cool. I could do that somewhat. I'm going to try. I'm going to try. But you lost 80 pounds. Bless your heart, girlfriend, because it take me forever just to lose like 5 or 10. So if you can lose 80, listen, you are on the right path to whatever success you want to have. But I would not constantly be kicking myself down because from your pictures, you look adorable and you and him look adorable. You taller than me. Bitch, you 5'9". I'm 5'3", okay? So, damn. And looking at your picture next to him, you look like you shorter than me because that nigga is tall as fuck. He's 7'3". Like, where the fuck do you even find that? Like, oh my God, I would have been scared to date him from the jump. Like, I don't think so. You're just too tall for me, Jolly Green Giant. No, thank you. No. You know what I mean? But either way, like, seriously, stop body shaming yourself and feeling like you're not attracted to him. Stop worrying about other bitches and what other people think, feel, and how they look. And worry about what you got going on in your relationship, okay? And how good he is to you. And in return, how good you are going to be to him. Because I guarantee you, Mamacita, you are not going to find someone so genuine like that. I mean, you will. I'm not saying that there aren't any like it, but they always seem to be hard to find. They're kind of hard to come across, you know? You go through the bullshit ones, and then when you find the right one, it's like, I didn't even know you was out there. All this time, you was right there in front of me, and I didn't even know. Like, you know what I'm saying? So you have to, and I have learned this for myself, I have learned to just chillax, relax. Over the last few weeks, I have learned to just do these things because a lot of things go on in my life, you know, like my knee is bothering me again, you know, because I have arthritis in it. So I'm happy that I'm still able to walk. A lot of people have so many ailments that they can't even function properly. And I would never want to compare myself to the next female. Though sometimes I do. Like, I look at one bitch and I'll be like, damn, I wish I looked like her. Wish my ass was like that. I wish my hips was like that. I wish my stomach was like that. You know, I wish my teeth was like that. You know, I do that a lot too, because we're never happy with ourselves. However, you also have to think about your boyfriend, Craig. He might feel the same way about some of his characteristics, but he just ain't saying nothing. So, my dear, enjoy the time you have with him and love every minute of it, because life is very short. And like I say always, life is short. So I'm not going to barrier myself and kick myself in the ass worrying about how she look and I don't look like them. I'm not going to do that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to enjoy my life and I'm going to enjoy how I look. And if nobody don't like how I look, well, then you know what? I don't give a fuck. Because at the end of the day, do you really think I give a fuck about if you don't like how my stomach looks, how my teeth look, how my ass look? No. Because if you don't like it, regardless if you're male or female, I don't want to be around you. If you're supposed to be my friend but you don't like how it looks, then bitch, you're really not my friend and I don't want to be around you, okay? And if you're supposed to be my boyfriend but you don't like it, and you suggested I lose this weight and I do this, then nigga, you really don't appreciate me for who the fuck I am. So therefore, I think I'm just going to, the first thing I'm going to do to get rid of is your punk ass, okay? That's gonna make me feel a whole lot better and look better as well without you near me. So yes, stop worrying about what these bad bitches look like at the basketball games, because I'm pretty sure your boyfriend is very aware they ain't nothing but groupies, regardless if it's college basketball, high school basketball, or whatever. Them bitches come in groupie sizes and all shapes and sizes and forms and all kind of basketball levels, meaning high school, college, and professional, okay? There are groupies for each level. There's levels to that shit. And if you ain't know, then bitch, I don't know what to tell you. But he already know. And he happy and content with what he got. So stop body shaming yourself and putting yourself down and be happy with what you got. Because there's a lot of men out there that are so thirsty and they don't give a fuck what a bitch look like. They just want some pussy from her. Or there's so men that are so egotistical and want the perfect bad bitch that he'll fucking pay for every body part on her, okay? Just so that she can look like what he wants her to look like. And you be like, god damn, you know, those are the ones that's just not happy with themselves. And they're probably doing things to just make themselves look better as well. Listen, let me tell you something I say all the time. All the time. Okay? Enjoy life. And stop worrying about what other people think about you and your life. And enjoy your shit. Because you're not promised tomorrow. And that's why I have stopped worrying about my stomach. Like, you know, I'm going to work out. And when it sheds off, it sheds off. And that's that. And I'm not going to stress myself anymore about it. Because stress is one thing I don't need, okay? Stress is one thing I don't need. But also, trying to compete with other bitches is another thing that I don't need either. What them bitches may have that you don't have, they may not have what you have. You know what I'm saying? Meaning you have the self-confidence and the moral standards for yourself. And you ain't no fucking groupie. And then they're total opposites. So you have to look at, would you rather be a thought? Okay? Or the person that you are. I'm just saying. It's about to be a new year, girlfriend. Be happy. I'm proud of yourself for losing 80 pounds. I wish I had that much motivation in me like you do, because Lord knows I sure need it sometimes. I sure do. Let Amy know what you guys would do in her situation. And we're going to move on to the last real talk. And we're going to end the new year with each other for this real talk. Okay? Okay, so I was just smiling because I love getting pictures in the emails. Like, I don't know why, because it's always great to put a face to an email. You know what I mean? That just gives me the opportunity to be able to just to see you and who I'm trying to help. But I just love it. And this picture just made me really smile because she was smiling so much. And she had her son in the picture with her, and I just loved it. And so anyway, it goes, April, first off, let me tell you, first of all, I freaking love your boldness and your sassiness. You are so beautiful, and I want to talk about a problem that I shouldn't have even put up with, but here it goes. Let's use the name Tammy and Randall. Randall and I have been talking for almost 2 years. We met online, and he has never given me any reason to feel like I'm important. Anytime I asked him to do anything, even on my dime, there was always a problem. I asked to just go to the park and talk, and that's free. He says that he has responsibilities. As well as, I have a 10-year-old son who I homeschool, and I also have SLE lupus, so I got shit going on too. I got my own place, and not once has he spent the night. He won't come around for real, but he tells me he loves me and he saw a future with me, but I never have. I believe it's a game. I'm moving back to Georgia, and now that it is a problem, he says he can't believe that I'm giving up on us. I'm like, what the hell? I have done all I can to get your attention. I can't let him mentally fuck me anymore. All I ever want was to be treated like a woman by him. I never wanted to just be something you do when you don't have nothing to do. Every day I question, what is it about me that makes him like this with me? I have a big heart, and all I want to do is be loved. I get random texts from him like, how are you feeling? What are you doing? And so, and every time I say something like, I need you, the conversation ends. Oh, okay, so whenever she responds and she says, I need you, the conversation ends, he doesn't respond. I know he don't love me, and when I leave Indiana, I don't see myself ever talking to him ever again. The 2 years that I have been here have been pure hell. So this chapter in my life, I'm closing. I don't want anything to do with this place, even though this is where I was born. This place doesn't feel like home. I never wanted to be up here. I came here only to get on my feet from illness. I've been called fat and ugly by family and men. It's been a long battle. I'm ready for my life to be about us only and for someone who wants to be there for me and my son. I have been through so much up here, and we are just ready to get on with our life. I said all this to say, do you think that what I'm doing will be the best for us? By the way, my real name is Erica. So, you know, Tammy, she said her real name at the end, but Tammy has been dealing with a guy that she met online for 2 years. Of course, they have met in person. You know what I'm saying? He'll come over whenever he's not busy. I guess basically when he's bored. He says he loves her and he sees the future with her, but he really does not show any affection or anything. Doesn't give her any time. Doesn't spend the night. Doesn't take her out. Doesn't wine and dine her. When she asks him to do something and on her dime, meaning she'll pay for it, he still says he can't. He has responsibilities. Can he come to the park and talk? He can't do that. He has responsibilities. It's always something with him. Always an excuse, an excuse, which really, really sucks, because you know what? When you put your heart into someone and you really, really be vibing and feeling someone, and then for them to shut you down like that, it is so hurtful. Like, totally, totally hurtful. And I could totally understand and get where she's coming from. You know what I mean? And like, the life in the world, life can be so cruel sometimes, and family and friends can be so cruel. How dare her family call her fat? How dare her family call her that? Like, this is what I be talking about. I said this last week and I said this week. Why the fuck are people so worried about what anybody's body shape and size looks like? Like, mind your fucking business and be happy with who the fuck you are as a person. If you were so goddamn happy with yourself, these little minor things in life that is not even minor things, but these things in life that make us all different because the world revolves around difference, okay? Then if this wouldn't even bother you, none of this would bother you. We cannot be the same. We cannot all wear size motherfucking 2. Lord knows I damn sure don't want to be that size. You just heard me bitch about, I don't want to be no size 135 pounds. I look like a crackhead. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to be that small. It's just so sad that some of these people, regardless if it's men or women, they see an opportunity because they're opportunists, and they like to take advantage of women or men because they feel like they're vulnerable or they're at their weak spot, and they feel like, you know what? I'm going to get over. I can get over on this person because they just feel like they don't have any self-esteem. And let me tell you something, Tammy. You're moving to Georgia? Listen, Linda, listen. Why do you think I moved here from Schenectady, New York, all the way across the country to Arizona to start my life over? Because the last few years in Schenectady were hell, and I was just so tired of it. It was a rundown state, so tired of it. I wanted something more for me and my kids, you know what I'm saying? And if I was to find true love, then hey, then that's great. But if not, I could care less. As long as I made myself and my children happier, then this was what I was going to do. And you know something? Family and friends, they never involved themselves with me when I lived in Schenectady and they were right there. They did not care enough. So why would I want to stagnate myself and stay behind just for people that really don't give a fuck about me? You know what I mean? This was the best decision and choice I could have ever made, is to move across the country. My daughter Tati always says, "Mommy, you are such a much happier person. You have changed a lot. I'm a nicer person." I ain't that motherfucking nice, because I still will cut your goddamn throat, but my attitude has changed a lot in life. And I will tell you this, I have moved here and I have become so positive and so happy, and I don't worry about what anybody thinks of me and or cares about me. I don't care, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm here in my lavish comfortability with my children in this beautiful state, and I'm happy where the fuck I'm at. And let me tell you something, Tammy, you have to do what makes you happy. You have to do what's good for you and your children. If he was really a man, a real man, then he would make it his business to come and visit you. But you know something, you have to close a chapter in your life and move on, because if you don't, then it's just going to hinder you and hold you up. You know what I'm saying? So with him being the type of person he is, he doesn't give you time. He only wants to come over when he ain't got shit to do and he's bored. Sweetheart, girlfriend, let me tell you something. You are stagnating yourself into a healthy relationship. You never know. Mr. Right could be on the other side of the door waiting for you in Atlanta, Georgia, wherever you're moving to. Don't stagnate yourself with somebody who is less of a person, who is not worthy of your time. Because if he's not making time for you, trust and believe, don't go giving your all and making time for him. It's time to be happy. Life is short. You guys don't realize that, like, yeah, I'm in my 20s. You be saying, I didn't say I was, but you know, y'all, I'm 20, freaknik, all this bullshit that y'all think. But you, by the time you know it, you'll be my age, 40. Listen, it felt like it was just like a couple years ago when I was in my 20s, okay? No lie, I really felt like that a few years ago. Now I'm 42 years old, okay? And it's like, damn, where does the time go? So enjoy yourself and do something that's healthy and good for you. You know what I'm saying? And this is what you want. And don't let nobody stop you from leaving the state, because people are going to have what they want to say. They're going to say what they want to say. But you know what? You think about it. Bitch, was you here for me? No. You were the one that was calling me names shit. Fuck you, okay? Live your life, sweetheart. It's a new year. It's about to be a new year. Live your life and fucking enjoy that shit to the fullest. Because I tell y'all what, a bitch like me gone, you 2017, a bitch gonna be real motherfucking happy. Trust and believe, real happy. I'ma turn up. I'ma be happy. I'ma be smiling. I'm glad that I'm working on my relationship again. You never fucking know where things go from here. But I tell you what, don't let anybody hinder you, and don't let anybody make you sad and miserable in life. Misery loves company. Don't be his motherfucking company. Okay, bitch? Don't. And you know something? Fuck what everybody thinks about your size. As long as you're happy and you living, fuck everybody else. Miserable people always got some shit to say about anybody. Always. Always. And I say it like this, as long as my children love me, I don't give a fuck about nobody else. These motherfuckers out here on YouTube, any type of social media that don't like me, fuck them all. I don't give a shit. As long as my kids love me, then that's all that matters. And that's all that should matter. So on that note, you guys, let Tammy know how you would take care of the situation. And what is your New Year's resolution? I told Tati my New Year's resolution is I ain't putting up with nobody's bullshit. She said, "Mommy, that was your New Year's resolution like 25 years ago. You've been doing that for like 25 some years now." So I ain't got no New Year's resolution. My New Year's resolution is to just be happy. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to say it's to lose weight, because everybody does that. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to do that. I'm not going to say this is what I'm going to do, because I've been trying to do that already. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to wait for a new year to lose weight. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take care of myself better, meaning my health. And I'm just going to be happy. That's it. And I'm going to enjoy life. So let me know what you guys' New Year's resolution is. And on top of that, I hope you guys enjoyed this real talk. Happy New Year to you guys. Bring it in with a bang. Don't get too drunk. If y'all bitches need a ride, a free cab ride, then there's a link in the description box for a free Uber ride or a free Lyft ride on me. So you guys can get your drunk asses the fuck home for free. Okay? So yes, I love you all. Stay diva and divalicious. Happy New Year. And I will speak to you guys soon. Hey.